Have you ever thrown a heavy object into a swimming pool and watched it float? Hi, I'm Dr. John Charles with NASA's Human Research Program. During the year-long International Space Station mission, NASA will conduct human factor studies to evaluate normal activities executed in a not-so-normal, low-gravity environment, like a swimming pool. The human factors investigations on the year-long International Space Station expedition will evaluate humans doing common, everyday human tasks. Just like objects floating in a swimming pool because of buoyancy, items float in space because of lack of gravity, making most simple tasks more challenging. Not only do astronauts have to evaluate how they will do something involving more than two items, since they only have two hands, but they will also have to secure things so they don't float away. As future missions become longer in duration and further from Earth, astronauts will depend less on mission control for real-time advice. Interactions between crew members and their equipment will need to be simplified so they can be able to react quickly without constant help from Earth. Studies will focus on the effects of fine motor performance and real-time livability in the space station. Crew members will execute a variety of tasks using various types of equipment and technologies, and their need for ground assistance and amount of time to conduct tasks will be measured. They will fill out periodic questionnaires using an electronic notebook, as well as being tested and their responses documented. This information will be valuable as NASA determines future habitability, volume, and other design needs in preparation for future missions to asteroids, Mars, and beyond. Here on Earth, these studies may lead to better designs for automobiles, simpler exercise equipment, and other ways to make life less complicated. To learn more about NASA's human research program, visit www.nasa.gov.